Welcome back to TenSlide Info. Whenever there is a tender from any country for aircrafts or fighters, there would be many similar fighters in the contenders list, and one such contender, which is common in both Malaysia and Argentina tender, is HAL Tejas of India. Malaysia's intention is to procure 18 fighter lead-in trainer light combat aircraft to replace its aging fleet of aircraft, which is currently serving both the roles. The Royal Malaysian Air Force procurement plan is for 36 fighters in two phases, 18 aircraft set to be purchased from 2021 and the rest from 2025 tentatively. The main intention, as already mentioned in my other video, is to replace the 18 Bay Systems Hawk Mark 108 twin seat and Mark 208 single seat LCAs. The major contenders in Malaysia's deal are Korea Aerospace Industries FA-50, Pakistan Aeronautical Complex JF-17 Thunder, Boeing T-7A Red Hawk, and Saab's Gripen C. Coming to Argentina, Argentina's intention is to procure the multipurpose fighter jets for up to $664 million budget to safeguard their airspace. And the main contenders for Argentina deal were Russia's Su-35, South Korea's FA-50, Sweden's Saab Gripen, and JF-17 Thunder. Even though there is no strong evidence about the participation of HAL Tejas fighters in both these procurement programs, there are news prevailing in the news sources and defense sources that HAL Tejas is also being considered for the tender by both Malaysia and Argentina. Not sure how much to trust these type of news, but if Tejas is participating in these two deals, there are high chances for this particular fighter to win the deal from both Argentina and Malaysia. Even if Argentina selects Tejas, there are certain constraints which needs to be taken care, and I'll be talking about this moving forward. As per the latest update, it looks like the Argentine Air Force has been inquiring about more details on Tejas fighter, along with the armament, the logistics, the performance, and various other parameters. The constraint which would stop further processing of this particular deal is the presence of British components in these HAL Tejas fighters. The major components of Tejas which needs to be replaced are the Cobham refueling probe, Martin Baker ejection seats, and Cobham quartz radome. Even if India plans to replace these UK components, it could require design changes and also another certification process for the entire system. Already HAL has so much backlog in the delivery list, so not sure if this can be even possible. Coming to Malaysia, the fighters which are in front runner are the Korea Aerospace FA-50 and again, according to few sources, India's HAL Tejas. In the case of Malaysia, there are no constraints for Tejas like removing the British components. So it is a challenge for HAL to sell it to Malaysian Air Force in a very easy environment. The other common fighter in both the above mentioned deals are the China's JF-17 Thunder, and there is no sign of this particular fighter winning any of these deals. In the case of Argentina, it is again the presence of British components due to which the United Kingdom won't allow the sales. And in the case of Malaysia, the reason is the collaboration of China in making these JF-17 fighters. How can Malaysia buy a fighter which is being manufactured by China when the problem for them itself is China? So let's hope India is able to sell their Tejas fighter to at least one of these countries. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to TenSlide Info for more defense and aviation related updates. Thank you.